What's happening, everybody? Trey here, joined again by my dad, Sean, and today we got some Creedence Clearwater Revival.
Said that fast five
times,
brother.
Some CCR. What I've heard of CCR, I really enjoy. I haven't heard today's track, though, Born on the Bayou, and you got a little backstory for us before we get
into it. Yeah, I haven't heard the song either. It's the B-side of Proud Mary off their second album, Bayou Country. Fogarty said that this song is about a mythical person growing up in the South, running around on the 4th of July. He did not grow up in the South. He's never run around in swampland like this describes. He said he actually wrote the song. He was sitting in a small apartment, nothing on the walls, said he couldn't afford anything. So he's staring at a blank wall, put his guitar down, and wanted to have what he called a pure songwriting experience. Writing about something that he knew nothing about, but convincing everybody that this was him. So many people believe this was him. It reminds me of another great songwriter, Bruce Springsteen, who talks about in Springsteen on Broadway how he's never really worked a day of hard labor in his life, but like 75% of his songs are about it. So I think that's kind of the mark of a great songwriter. They convince
get him to
us.
Believe.
Yeah,
you know?
We believe. So I'm excited to hear this thing, man.
Me too. We got the lyrics pulled up here. We'll be looking down at that, following along with the tune, and pausing every now and then. And yeah, let's get rocking.
Let's do it. Interesting album cover.
Yeah, I'm almost a little psychedelic-like even. It is the late 60s, though.
CCR sound, baby.
I've noticed Fogarty's got a little more grit and roughness to his voice than a lot of the songs I've heard.
He does, but I'll tell you one thing about Fogarty that I noticed from the songs I'm familiar with. That boy never goes halfway in, right?
No.
This man sings with some power and some passion. I like this. Now, when I was just a little boy in verse one, standing to my daddy's knee, my papa said, so I mean, this kid's probably three, son, don't let the man get you and do what he's done to me, because he'll get you now. So I'm guessing he worked a hard manual labor job and telling him, so don't ever work for the man, work for yourself. And then he describes running around in the backwoods, which never happened because he said he's never even been to Louisiana or the Bayou.
Some great imagery in that second verse.
Definitely.
As well. Sets the scene well. And
I was wondering when we got to the hook if I would recognize her, if I'd actually heard the song, but I have not. So let's rock it.
Fogarty showing those guitar skills that he has as well.
Mm.
Got that cowbell in there.
Yes.
Think?
Here's what I thought. It's 5 minutes and 15 seconds long. I think it would have been a much better song for me if it was 4 minutes long.
See, I was going to say the same thing.
I think the instrumentation ran on too long with not any change up in it. You know, I thought the first solo part was a little long, and then we got hit with that little mini one again.
Yeah.
And I just thought the instrumentation was too long. And I know if you love CCR, you probably love that. I just thought we listen to so much music that I want that solo to give me something a little different. And it doesn't really lend to it in this song to go off on some crazy guitar riff, but they could have shortened that some for me.
I was going to say the exact same thing. I liked, I enjoyed the track for, from the choruses, the verses and whatnot, but I'm with you. I think if we just maybe cut that instrumentation down 30 seconds here or 45 seconds, it would have made for a little bit more tight, compact song. But that's not to say that I dislike the tune.
I mean,
with Fogerty's voice and the way that CCR is just able to evoke that imagery, that swamp type of setting that you can just follow.
Even though Fogerty's from Southern California, I love it, man.
Exactly. So not one of my favorite CCR songs, but even so, it was still a good track. So for me, I'm going to be at like a 7.0 on this song.
Wow. We're on the same path on this. I was going to be at exactly at a 7.0 as well.
But I definitely want to react to some more CCR. We recently listened to Cosmos Factory
Full.
What a tremendous, tremendous record.
And I'm familiar with some of their biggest hits, obviously, and love them. Maybe it's just because I heard this for the first time. It doesn't resonate as much. But we really appreciate you stopping by. If you liked what you saw, please hit that big thumbs up. Leave us a comment if you disagree with us. Also, please hit that big red subscribe button. We do all kinds of stuff at the channel. Track-by-track reviews of albums. We do live streams. We do song reactions. There's something for everybody. How else can they connect with us?
You can hit us up on our Discord or Facebook groups. The links are down below. Go to music community there.
Excellent.
As well as our Patreon if you'd like to support us for as little as a dollar a month. And also get some perks yourself. That helps us out. And I guess we will see y'all next time. Happy listening, my friends. And we will see you.